Hello, my name is Scott McKenzie and I'm an avionics tech rep here at Duncan Aviation. We frequently get calls from customers that have an Avidyne EX500 or EX600 MFD installed in their aircraft and the interfaces aren't properly configured to their unit, not allowing them to work properly. Today we're going to show you how to go through the configuration and set it up for your aircraft. First thing we'll do is power the unit on and wait for the splash screen to appear and then hit the bezel key to continue. Next, we'll select the aux tab. We're going to press the top line select key and the third from the top line select key and hold them in for about 5 seconds, and that is going to put the MFD into maintenance mode. First of all, we'll go into the GPS setup. Our options available here are Gamma 429, King Aviation, which is an RS-232, North Star, which is also a RS-232, and NMEA. The most common formats available would be the King Aviation format. Any RS-232 interface should have this selected, with the exception of a North Star receiver. The preferred format would be Gamma 429 because that would allow you to use the GPS FMS as a heading source. If you have a second GPS, you can use that, configure that as a backup with the same formats available. You can have two receivers interface via Gamma 429 or one Gamma 429 and one RS-232, but you cannot have two RS-232 GPSs configured to the Avidyne. Next, we'll go into traffic setup. Our options available here are TIS, TISG, RS-232, and TCAS. So we can select any of those options, or if there is no traffic sensor installed, you can select not installed. Our lightning setup, there are two options available, the TWX670, which is the Avidyne lightning sensor. All of the options here are single click, so there are not really any changes to be made there if that's the receiver that we have installed. If you have a WX500 installed, the big option that we'd want to check here is the stabilization type. You can use map heading track, stepper, or synchro. Synchro and stepper are the preferred options, but if those are not available, you can use the map heading track. Also, we can select the enable lightning ahead warning, which will put a message on the message bar anytime a lightning strike is detected on the front of the aircraft, and then also a selection for where the antenna location is on the aircraft. If it's on top, we check it, and if it's on the bottom, we leave that unchecked. Our TOS setup, if there's not a receiver, we can select not installed, or it can be configured with any Honeywell EGPWS with Phase 2 software or later. Next, we'll go to map heading. Our options here are GPS track, synchro, or FMS GPS. Again, on the FMS GPS, if we're using that as the selected map heading source, the GPS that is interfaced to the Avidyne needs to be in an ARINC 429 format for that to be able to be used. Any ARINC 407 synchro input is acceptable for the synchro option for map heading. The last resort option would probably be the GPS track. That will only be available once the aircraft is moved. Finally, we can get into aircraft setup. Here's where we can get our weather receivers interfaced. If you have an Avidyne MLX 770 receiver, that is selected via the narrowcast option. Or the broadcast, we have XM radio, Sirius, and Skytrax 100 radio, which is the Avidyne ADS-B receiver. So we can select that there. We can also select our dimming voltages for the backlighting for the unit to properly match the instrument panel. And that will conclude the configuration for the Avidyne EX500 and EX600 multifunction displays.